Hi, everybody. This is Kat with the Instructional Tech Team. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up an assignment in Canvas. So when you log into Canvas and you choose one of your classes, you're going to come over here to the left-hand side and you're going to select Assignments. From Assignments, in order to make a new one, does the same thing within Announcements and Discussions. You're going to click over here where it has plus assignment. You're going to add an assignment. You can also add a group of assignments if you want to like chunk and organize the way that you're doing things in your class. So it would kind of make it look like another module. When you add a new assignment, it's going to give you a number of features. The easiest way is to do it within the sidebar. There's also a way to do it within your calendar. If you watch the calendar video, it'll show you how to add an event, but there's also a tab for adding an assignment. So here, I'm going to go ahead and call this one pretend fake assignment, fake classwork. It can be classwork, it can be homework, it can be snow day, things that they need to make up. It can be additional things for your AP students. It can be things for your parents to do at home. You're going to title it. Here you add whatever it is you need, like read the following article and summarize, blah, 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 blah. There's a couple ways to do this. We've had a lot of teachers right now, their content is still in Word, their articles, things like that. And so what they've been coming over to the right, clicking on files and uploading a new file. That's fine. It'll work. You choose the file, you find it within your Common Drive, wherever you have it stored. You choose whatever it is. And then you, so let's say it was, let's do that one. I can choose a file, then I'm going to upload it here. While it's trying to upload, that takes a while and people are asking about how much space they have. If you are using Google Drive, that's really not necessary and it's much faster. So we have videos showing you how to upload and convert those if you go to our website. But let me show you a faster way. So let's say it says reading the following article. I can right click here for article. Or I could also just highlight there. What you're going to do is you're going to link them. So I can highlight it. I'm going to click this link to URL. Once you're using a Google Doc, Google Docs are nothing more than actual web addresses. They're not files stuck on your computer. They're linked online. So I can click this link button. I'm going to go to my drive. And let's say I want to grab this document, this article, the slideshow, whatever it is that you want that's within. I can click on it and I'm going to click right here for the link and I'm going to get my shareable link. I want to make sure that it's only viewing rights unless I want them actually typing in it. So I'm going to grab this link. I'm going to copy it and I am going to paste it right here and I'm going to insert the link. So now my students are going to read the following article and they're going to summarize it. I could have even linked it right here with the word article. So I've given their assignment. I've linked what it is that they're going to do. It's going to bring them there. You could also send them to a website. You could have them watch a YouTube video. You could give them whatever it is that you need, insert it there. I could also insert an image. I can come over here to the right-hand side. I could choose some image from Flickr if I wanted, or if there's an image I already have. I can have them, let's say, an image of an ant. I could choose that image. It's going to insert it. I could have them discuss it. Whatever it is that I need, I can put it in here for my assignment. Once your assignment's created, you're going to give it a point value that you want. You can, if it was part of a group, you could put it into that group here. You can have it display as percents, letter grades, or just points. This part is important. How do you want them to turn in their assignment? Do you want them to just write their answer? Then that's text entry. If you want them to make a Google Doc or something and submit it to you, that is a website URL. That is not a file upload. File is if it's Word or something that's tied to the desktop. If they're making a Google Doc or a slideshow, they're submitting a website URL. If they're uploading and making video things, creating green screens, that's going to be a media recording or you have an old school file upload. You can make it a group assignment. You can let them actually review each other's work. That work can then be anonymous. You can assign their groups that they're, who they're going to review, or you can let the computer randomly generate that for you. This is the magical button. If you keep it clicked, it's already set to automatically be clicked. Post to SIS means that if when Canvas grades it, it will automatically put it into your power, into your power school. So you don't have to grade in Canvas and then go and re-enter the grades. The computer will do the work for you. So that should save you time. This is also great as far as differentiating instruction. You can assign that assignment to everyone in your class, or if you want, you can assign it to an individual student. You can make groups of students and then assign different work. So maybe I want to differentiate and have a different assignment for my English language students versus my students with an IEP with an accommodation versus my students who are gifted and talented and I need to increase the rigor for them. So you can differentiate your assignments here. You can give them due dates, when they have to turn it in, and when you're all done, you can save it, or you can save and publish it. When you publish it, that's when students can see it. So sometimes I build things early and I just save it, but I don't publish it until it's time. So now when I go to my assignments, this is my assignment specifically, if I want to go ahead and edit it or if I want to publish it, or I can go back to all my assignments and I'll see it in my list where I can publish it from there as well. So I might have a number of things as a teacher in my assignments, but I only want my students to see. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things in here, but really all I want you to be able to see is I want you to see that one. If I want it to go into the grade book, post to SIS, I can click it there. If I don't want you to see it, I can unpublish it. This one was a quiz, so it's not going to let me turn off a quiz. So that's doing assignments. And if you need any other instruction, go to our YouTube channel and you'll find plenty of videos there.